Hi, everybody. Welcome back to our video course on rapid wireframing. My name is Billy Carlson, and I'm a design educator here at Balsamiq. In this video, we're going to talk about creating polished wireframes. We can use this just to give you another option that you can show your clients, your stakeholders, or just a friend that you're trying to get feedback from. So as you can see, we have all of our wireframes on different screens. And what we can do is change the style of it so it looks more like a website than a sketchy wireframe. So the first thing you're going to do is go to your project here. And the dropdown, you can go to style, and it says sketch, which is what we just did previously. And let's go to clean, best for presentation. So as you notice, the sketchiness sort of goes away, and we're left with something that looks a little more polished. There's no rough edges, everything is clean. So the next thing we're going to do is change the typeface. So we'll go back to our project menu here, and we'll go to fonts and colors and click that. And in the center of the screen, it gives me options of different fonts, default font size, and colors and links. We'll just change this to Open Sans. That's one of my preferred sans serif typefaces. And we'll keep everything else the same and close that. All right, so what I want to do now is just show you what the design looks like, and then we could talk about ways to clean it up even more so that it looks closer to a final product. And that way we can get better feedback from stakeholders, clients, or users. Some things I'm noticing are proportion sizes. This is a little different than this, but not enough. So maybe we can update these designs. Little details. And the details do matter, but we're also, again, still in the wireframing phase. So we don't need to really worry too much. The first thing we can do is clean up this spacing. So I've started a little bit. And I just want to show you sort of a really easy way to do that is to make each of these their own group. So if you select the text, hold on the shift and select the background color, and then press Command G or Control G, depending on Mac versus PC, and then it'll create a group. Okay, now that I've grouped each of them on their own, I'm going to select them all and click on the option of space out horizontally. And now make sure that's equal space across. I'm going to do a little other touch-up things here so that everything's even. This is the only thing not supposed to be even. So I'm just clicking into the height and using the arrow down key on my keyboard to change the height to 34. And so now this text box is in open. So now another thing I want to do is maybe work on the spacing. I like the idea in the previous alternate, which I can show you. We got rid of the box here and it looks a lot better in my opinion. So group it, hold on the shift key, select the background and center it again. I really like this design. It works well with the clean polish. So I'm going to copy that and go back to the official version and paste it right back in there. The reason why I like this design is this is sort of more highlighted than, and then this also sort of adds hierarchy. This is a little more important on the screen than the cart. I don't want the color of the button to be as prominent as it was, but the placement of the cart gives it enough importance that most users would automatically look in the top right of a screen to find the cart in an e-commerce experience. Very common. So I am going to change this and I'll select this thing. I selected blue because it's a color dark enough to have the white text read over it. In the terms of hierarchy, in terms of glancing at the screen, this color will pop out pretty well. And also, again, its placement will be really helpful. I want to change this to match. Now I'll get rid of this background here. And I'll take this and I'll hold on to the Option and Shift key to drag it over. I'm going to hold on the Shift key again and select the background. Send everything to back. Now I have this reversed out back button that we can use on every screen. And copy it and put it everywhere, right? Things that change when you change a typeface or the font and you change from the sketch to the straight clean lines is sometimes it's just misaligned and not placed correctly. What I want to do is select everything here and make sure it's centered correctly. On this screen, maybe just move everything down a little bit. And look at the other design too.
Okay.
Had the same already. You can hint at the idea of truncating text by using dot, 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 which means that we only have a specific size for this. And if it goes over it, then we just truncate the text so that it fits. That looks good. I like that this has a darker color than this background. This is an input field, and this is just to highlight the color a little more. And when I show this to our UI designer, they can get that sense of balance. We want this to stand out. The name of the product and the price are really important, and I think this design shows that, and it still lends itself to have this search bar stand out as well. I want to check out the alternate version for this as well. I like this design. I don't think much needs to change. It looks pretty good. It works well in both formats. Just some slight things in here, like these don't need to be as off-center as they are. I could use an icon in here. To use an icon, it's very simple. I've showed you this trick. I would just hit the slash key on my keyboard, and I would type in minus, and it just does dash. And then I could do that again and just type in plus. Just another way to do it. Doesn't really matter to me. I will keep that for now, but I think this looks good. It sort of hints at what I'm looking to do. This would be a carousel of images. Here is our section for title and description. This is the price. The price is bold. As a designer, you'd get a really good sense of how to lay the screen out. Our pop-up is pretty close. I noticed that these weren't exactly in the center of the buttons. There you go. And how I just check is I just sort of eyeball it. If I zoom out, it looks okay. I think the intention behind it is that they're centered and they're square. Bringing this into high fidelity visual design, I may treat these differently. But to me, this gives a great sense of what I want it to be, which is, you know, secondary, primary. So I like these rounded buttons better than what I had here. So I'll do that really quick. And they were gray. See what that looks like. I'm liking the way this has gone. I just went down twice in the keyboard. So I eyeball it myself just to make sure it looks right to me. These all seem to work. This seems like this character length is enough. We could drop it down to a next line, but I think it works. Having this much space is fine. Maybe we want to bold these. They are important, but it is also reflected up here. Oh, this looks good. Okay, final screen. It's not following exactly the width of everything. Overall, I think it looks great. Nothing much needs to change here. That's it. That's how you make a rough balsamic wireframe into something a little more polished. You use the style clean and change your typeface from Balsamiq Sans to something else. That's it. Thank you. See you next video.